Welcome back, everyone, and I hope you're having a good weekend so far. I've done some of the work, like I shared. I just can't really decide what to finish it off with. That's why we're not going to completely finish it today. Like, we're not going to do part of it yet. And you might be going, but you said you were going to do it, and I apologize. I just kind of need to fit the timing. Now, these were supposed to have grown already, and they're getting there, but some of them are still growing, so we'll leave that for now. We're going to just put that here because I'm starting to collect more chorus flowers, and we're going to have to take a look at the other thing that we're doing. And for this side of it, I completely haven't got a clue how this will go. So, one moment. We shall be adding some of the work to this village. I know I said I was going to change the village, and I don't have the time, and don't have the time, and sometimes don't have the time. So, we're going to start part of the terraforming and try our best to actually get this going because, as you can tell, we need to finish what we promise. And I was saying I'm going to be upgrading this village, so let's just actually start doing that. One, two, three. We need a big space here, but let's just see. This is three as well. I was like, I think it's three. I think it's three. One, two, three. So it starts here. Perfect. Yeah, I kind of don't know what exactly we're going to do, but I figured we need to start actually finishing projects, and I should take time off of everything else to finish things. And currently, that's why the next step, unfortunately, would need to be, for instance, this village. So there we go. We're going to turn here. So there's that. The incorrect positions because that one we can just make grass again. Not that we need to, but there we go. We just kind of need to start finishing things off for ourselves, and that's why this is slightly wonky, and this will be slightly frustrating for you guys to watch, and I apologize, but we just need to actually spend time on things like this for us to actually succeed at finishing projects. Because I say I want to finish things, and then I start a little bit, and then I touch it a little bit, and then I'm like, cool, I'm not doing much, and then I don't do much. You've obviously seen that, so you can understand what that feels like. I'm just going, I need to actually get consistency. So we will just manage this over and over, and I need to start bringing villagers back here and set it up so that it's safer and lit up and towers. You know, we need guard towers. I'm pretty sure you know that. That's why we're going to be making sure that we have those. Okay, there we go. I know that this is slightly frustrating to watch, so I'm just going to quickly finish the rest of the wall, well, the part of the wall, and then we'll go on the next step. I'll have to work out how to wrap it correctly and things like that, but now the wall goes the whole way around. We just need to do the connections, and you can see there are places where there's dirt underneath. I'll fix that eventually, but that won't be what we do today. So let's just head through this way. I kind of don't know exactly what to put here. The way that I was lining things up, we could adjust by making this wall slightly further and things like that, but I'm just not convinced to do any of that. I'm thinking we should build like a castle over here. I just kind of need people's opinions for that. But that isn't what we're doing next. So next, we're going to start in one of the corners, and I figured might as well be a corner closest to our house, our first house. So we're going to start over here. I currently have the plan that we'll use the bone blocks for the support pillars, like so. And with that, the next step would be quickly grabbing some stairs. So let's just grab 6 of those and grab the oak stairs. And doing this. And accidentally placing it placing 2 of them immediately. So like so. I'm kind of just trying to work out how to make this look aesthetically pleasing. And here we'll do stairs, actually, when we pick them up, like so. And then the connecting part here, we should actually pay attention to this. Yeah, I was correct. Oh, I didn't want to drop in here and have to do this these stairs again, but there we go. I'm slightly silly sometimes, like so. So there and there, and we can just grab that. And then in these connections, I think it should be a maximum of 2 up, but where it's more, we'll do a stairway. But now I'm thinking about it. What would be the next step here? I suppose because we're using these 4 columns that are supporting everything, we should just do that. And let's just actually make ourselves another few. That should work out. 12 is divisible by 6. Like so. And I'm just kind of guessing at how this will actually look in the end. So I'm sure somebody will have tips and things going, no, you shouldn't do this. You should probably use this because it'll look better and things like that. I would appreciate that because I'm just not convinced. And I think, let's grab the crafting table again and jump and stand on it again. Let's just make some slabs. I think we do those upside down. I suppose we can make it square on the inside, maybe. But I'm not completely convinced. And then that. So let's just hop off and head up this way so that we can take a look at it from over here. Now the lighting is going to take me a long time, so we're not going to even touch that today because I still need to light up so many of the areas, and I just hope we can see it from here. Those look like decent towers. And that's using the oak. I think it would make sense for us to just do something slightly different for the fences. So let's make it divisible by 5 and finish him off quickly. Divisible by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. And fences. Now this, I will hope, looks decent at least. So that's why we're going to quickly try it out. I don't want the colors for the main wall parts and the stairs to be the same. But I also don't want to fall off when we get shot by skeletons and things, as you can tell. He's still shooting at us, but that's okay. We're just prototyping this. So that looks okay. We would need lighting, actually. You know what? Let's just make it look larger. There we go. Cool. I'm going to just think about it for a bit, and we'll be back. So the next thing that we're going to do, because it needs work, is slightly different. We're going to just be adjusting these railway lines, but this is going to take a little bit of time, as you can no doubt tell. I kind of figure we should work out the way that it's completely minimal, because we don't get saplings out there, we don't get anything like that, and I kind of figure this will need an upgrade for us to use more regularly, because as you can obviously tell, we regularly need wood and we regularly don't have enough. So I want to make it slightly more reliable for collecting saplings, and I think that's making it a smaller line here. Now, this is probably just going to be what we do here. I kind of figure the system for collecting it up here at the top is fine, although it does need some adjustments, like it's just sort of okay. I was like, what was that? It was one of the grey carpets. There we go. So I figure we will first just need to pick up all of the railway tracks. And for that, we'll go as close as we need to here. But that should be a good area for starting this. So let's just make this easier for ourselves. We've got that shulker box over there. We can place that back. So let's just make a way for us to get up here. Perfect. We will collect all of this and start building it up again for ourselves. I'm just also thinking of how to redo the lighting and things like that. I would love tips from people. So let's just see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think 5 is where we should go up to. Right. So there we go. I kind of figure that that should be alright, but I'll need people's opinions, firstly, and secondly, tips and tricks. Like, maybe you've done this for yourself and you know how big we'll need to make it, because I'm not completely convinced. Okay, actually I shouldn't have taken those away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so it'll go up to there, and we'll lose some blocks, but we can just stick them back when we get them. Ooh, there. So I think that would be a good place to map it, and for that we can actually change all of this, because you can see we had a little bit of a struggle, but doing it this way I think should be better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it'll go up to there. Okay. Perfect. And it is slightly bigger than the 5 that I was saying, but it's just for the turning tracks and things like that. So let's just see how we can do this. So I'm going to just pick up the tracks around the borders, and then we'll be back. Alright, so this should hopefully make more sense. So that one goes through there, then turns around, then turns around here, but we can do a little bit of powered rails. Not like that. That happens regularly. And then we can turn around here. There we go. Let's just actually put another 2 powered rails there. Like, this is going to be way faster, and I have no idea if it's going to actually succeed or not. So there, I went 3 here. So we'll just make that two. Because I think we should actually go out a little bit further. And hopefully it'll pay off. I figure this might be a large enough area. But I think I might be getting it completely wrong as well anyway. So there we go. Seeing as we come back this side. There we go. And we'll just pick that up and move it over and put these here. Now, in theory, this should work out. We just want to make sure that this is going as fast as it can. So let's just pick that up and place that over there. And that should now be running all the way around. There we go. I feel like that's half to two-thirds of the time. But let's just see if it can collect all of the saplings besides the ones that we'll get in a moment. So like so. And then we'll fall in again. There we go. Come on. Let's just try and parkour our way over. I didn't think this through. There we go. There we go. There. And jump. Perfect. We made it. So let's just quickly chop down the tree. And we'll see. We should get more consistent saplings collected. More consistent sapling collection. I had to think that through. There we go. And it's slightly dark, but hopefully you guys can see perfectly. I need to adjust the settings slightly again, as you can no doubt tell. But it's getting there. I forgot. We don't have that one log there. Let's just see. I hope we can get all of them. We can't. Okay. You know what? That's okay. We'll fix it. There we go. Okay. It was good. I was like, that should be close to the top of the tree. Perfect. There we go. Now, the last little bit down. And I want to see the saplings reliably collected. There we go. We can pretty much leave most of that here. Because this timing should be way better. And it'll help us see if it's better. So there we go. There's a sapling. Picked it up. There's another sapling we just saw. Ah, it doesn't pick that up through there. When we have these, does it actually pick them up? Let's just actually test that. Okay. So there and there. What we'll do is we'll just throw a piece of wood there and a piece of wood there, and we'll wait for it because it's slightly quicker, and so that makes it slightly more reliable. Let's just see. Should pick up both. Ah. That's why we rarely got. It's because they were dropping on the stairs. All right. So for the next episode, I'm going to finish off putting this all back, but that is where we're going to leave it today. And I have to thank you guys for watching, but have a great weekend, and I hope you're having an awesome time. Cheerio.
infinite power.